And the average lifespan of a Lancaster was 40 hours. Just 40 hours, okay? Over half of them were lost, okay, from the ones that were built, all right? So, we've got that big Bombay. And basically, what's so clever about the Lancaster is that the Bombay is composed of 16 different sectors, okay? And each of those sectors has an electrical connection so that you can put a bomb or a cartridge that contains bombs into that sector. In the nose of the aircraft, right up there in the bomb aimers panel, you can actually see it through the window. Can you see the bomb aimers panel, the top left-hand side, that first panel has got lots of switches all in the upward position. Can you see that? Yeah? Just inside there on the left-hand side. And each one of those is what turns on, the switch that turns on, that drop sector in the bomb bay. Okay? So just a big space. And because bombs were different sizes, you've got 4,000 pounders, 1,000 pounders, this is a 1,000 pounder just here. 250 pounders, okay? And of course you also have the boxes that carried the incendiary.
Thank you.
Now we're looking at a period that is really late 41, 1942 onwards, okay? This is what we call battle dress. And battle dress is a thick woolen serge uniform. Brilliant. Anybody who's done national service will know all about battle dress, okay? We actually, well, I particularly like battle dress. I think it's a smart uniform. I think it's a very good uniform. It's very durable. And when battle dress was issued, they used to say for 6 months, you would stand there itching like crazy, because they used to actually shave battle dress on the inside to stop the itching, okay? For the next 6 months that you wore it, everything was fine, and you looked quite smart. But for the final 6 months that you wore battle dress, before being issued with the itchy stuff again, you looked like you'd been dragged through a hedge backwards, okay? But it's really, really good stuff. Trousers, the actual trousers button to the battle dress blouse. This is called battle dress blouse. They actually button and attach, which is a great idea till you sit down and you stand up again. Then you have interesting things happening, like buttons flying off everywhere. Rank of flying officer, so the rank stripes go onto the epaulettes, okay? And within that battle dress could be many other things. Minus 50 and minus 60 degrees centigrade, okay? Neil being a nav, he's got a heater under his bench. And he actually can be quite toasty inside the Lancaster, even at a reasonable height. It's also got engines either side of him, which is quite handy too. But his decision is, do I put the full kit on, because I may end up in the North Sea. And if he's dressed like this with just his parachute harness on and his May West, he's going to get cold a lot quicker than the guys who've got the full warming kit on. So that's a decision that he will have to make, okay? He's also got the pink hat on, with the King's Crown, because of course it's King George V at this time. And when you ever see an RAF person salute, you'll notice they do not salute people who do not have a hat on, okay? And the reason for that is they are saluting the king, they are saluting the crown, okay? So if you are caught and there's a senior ranking person walking past you and you have no hat on, you stand and show him the respect, but you do not salute him or you'll be on a charge, okay? So they salute the king's warrant, which is what he's wearing on his hat.